Mourning Kaddish, poem by Scott Weinstein, music by John Coltrane. Spiritual. Blessed are the fighters. We met at a Christmas party for lonely hearts. I wore a tight silver shirt, and Em wore a tight silver dress that neither of us found attractive. We met for dessert at Santropol. Em was late. We met again for lunch at Chez Jose. Em was late again. We met again for breakfast at the Green Cafe. And fuck me if Em was late. Is this going somewhere? I don't think you want it to. I didn't say that. It's what you're thinking. We made love. Em was the funniest person I ever met. Em had anger management issues. Em was part of many people's lives. Em was an empath. She played accordion in a woman's street band, wrote poetry and short stories, never went to sleep before midnight, read books from back to front to middle, and stayed working class. Em talked with a raspy voice. Your room is so quiet. I can really sleep. If I get a dog, will you help take care of it? I moved in. We shared two dogs. We walked and talked on the mountain to Em's radiation, chemo, and doctor's appointments at the general. It was a beautiful way to experience cancer. Em got her master's in anti-capitalist economics. We marched for Palestinian solidarity, for the environment, against racism, for printemps Arab, bang casseroles. Em had a young daughter who asked me, how is your day? One day I picked up Em's daughter at school to take her to the emergency room. On vacation, they told me, drive with both your hands on the wheel. I still do that. We fought for control on our tandem bicycle. Traveling with Em was to be present to the Pakistani truck drivers in the Himalayas and the Saint Laurent River communities and desert canyons and Las Vegas schlock and the New York subway stranger who guided us and the damaged guy who gave us candy and Mountain Dew at a cemetery in Lake Charles, Louisiana, and said, God bless. Em wrote a story about the Los Alamos Atomic Bomb History Museum that decontaminated the history of Japanese dead. May you have abundant peace. We stayed in conflict. I moved out. I stayed at Em's house. We got help. I joined Em's daughter and newborn granddaughter in the Dominican Republic. Em, while visiting, thrilled to be a grandmother, enthralled by whales breaching nearby, wrote, life is for living, eh? Then upped and died. Just like that. There are many teachers teaching lessons to learn how to lose someone. I think about Palestinians. Teach me how to lose thousands. My Jewish mother lost her religion. My Buddhist mother said, I love you, to my brother and me after taking her final morphine before she stopped breathing. I wonder if Palestinian mothers have that luxury. Buddhists say, accept and be present. I need Em to comfort me about Em being dead. Em understood Coltrane. I listened to Coltrane. Alice Coltrane said, John's death was beautiful. Laurie Anderson said, death is the release of love. I say goodbye to to our patients in my hospital ward after they die. Mary Lynn said, "You don't get over grief, you just get through it." And the co-op meetings are dreary without M. Mike Tyson said, "Everyone's got a plan until they get punched in the face." Ain't that the truth? M's laughing community stopped laughing. We ask, "How are you? How are you?" My distant family came together again. M died soon after cousin Bruce and nephew Elliot. Young, vibrant, beautiful. The old bury the children. Friends and I came together. M's family and I came apart. Time passes backwards. I think about Palestinians. Norma read the names of the dead when it was only 3,000. Maria Al-Masri, Tia Abu Jahar, Alma Mohammed Hamdan. I grieve and rage with comrades at protests and direct actions. Kaddish. We have joy. We are present. We are everywhere. My friend Martha, after coming home protesting for Gaza, told me she felt wonderful, knowing that her suffering would end with her planned medically assisted suicide tomorrow, surrounded by her children. Death is a virus, roaming around my body and soul. I discovered some things inside me are no longer alive. I think about Palestinians, a lot of dead Palestinian children, and a lot more children expecting to die by the bombs from my country given to my people who cashed in on our genocide to commit genocide. I now smell the putrid rot inside our Jewish temples, worshiping the Zionist state and the IDF. I sense something huge died inside our liberal empire. I feel scavengers circling overhead. But Palestinians? These Palestinians? I'm talking about death right now. These Palestinians are resisting, motherfuckers. These Palestinians refuse to die. M is not experiencing Gaza. It would break her heart, but not her spirit. M is singing, "Viva, viva, Palestina!"